Hi everyone, this is Gronico. I'm going to showcase this Suzuka. Well, I already maxed Kaigan all her gates, plus with the equipment equipped and the gear, everything. Then, her overall status is okay. Except for the physical attack, the rest is average. The physical attack is overshot. And then, for her leader skill, well, this is a third gate bonus. It increased the physical attack 30% and all attack 20% and HP 20%. So this leader skill is very good for light attackers. And then for her main skill, okay, her first skill is a permanent increase her slash buff 1.4 and also increase the evasion, but all her elemental resistance down, and this buff cannot be override, so it's permanent buff. So if you want to increase her overall attack, it's very good to use from the start, since her physical defense and magic defense is not really that high. So after the elemental resistance down, doesn't affect so much actually. And then next is, it is a light slash attack and also ignore the enemy defense and good against the metal unit, but I think seldom of the enemy is metal type. And this is the most powerful skill in her main skill. But this skill, the range is only 1, so beware. And then, this is when you master her 5th gate. It is an aerial light slash attack and the damage will be increased if there's a lot of enemy is within the area. So this skill is more for attacking multiple enemies. But then if you never master the 5th gate, there's no changes for the Blade Master job plus for this skill, so beware. And then for the last skill, it is a slash attack and also ignore the defense and penetrate the enemy and also good against the monster. And the range is 3, 1 straight line. So this is the second skill which have the ignore the defense. And of course, you're fighting against a monster, the damage increase. Nothing much actually. And then this is the side ability. Well, I'll not go through this 1-2-3 skill since there's nothing much to go through. I will only go through the last skill. It's a slash attack with penetrate effect. And for the one turn, her physical attack times 1.5. And the enemy will have the slash resistance gradient down for 3 turns. And the range is a 1 straight line 3, okay as well. And then for her reaction skill, it is a first strike counter attack and also ignore the enemy defense and has 100% hit and probability of healing disabled status and skill candy animator. So this skill is actually very good since it's a 100% first strike counter, but the range is only 1, so beware. And then for the passive, okay, this passive is when you master her second gate. You only add extra the slash attack up, the rest is the same. Increase the physical attack and magic attack a lot and reduce the physical defense and magic defense. So this is a compulsory to equip for her passive. And the second passive is, well, this is from the Blade Master old passive, but it's still very good. It greatly increase the physical attack and also increase some evasion but reduce her speed. So these two passives will be the best for her. And then for the master ability, okay, it increase her maximum HP and speed and slash attack up. And also the reaction skill from the Dark Cabra, Dark Knight power-ups. But then this adventure power-ups is, it is just a 100% counter attack, but only activate when the opponent is using physical attack and skill will not activate. So this skill is a bit outdated, since if the opponent using skill, this reaction will not activate. So I wonder why they never adjust this reaction skill into skill can be activated and some effect instead of just a normal counter attack. So this master ability for this upgrade is a bit useless right now. And then for the mementos, okay, this is her free Valentine mementos you can get from her job plus event. And then the overall status increase, not bad, especially the physical attack up and speed up and slash attack up and counter attack. All this group skill is quite good. And then it's also very easy to max break as well. And then for the next mementos, this second mementos is a limited swimsuit summon mementos. Well, the overall group skill increased much more better than the free one because of the single attack damage up and also the light attack up and strong versus a dart and also reduce her jewel cost. So all this group skill is very good. And then if you master this mementos, the last group skill adds extra the skill usage plus 1. So out of a skill have one more usage. So you can use both of the powerful skill one more time. Very good actually. And then for the reject ability, it is an area like slash attack. If the opponent has the slash resistance down, this skill attack power ups plus light resistance down for the enemy for 3 turns. And the range is a 3 and 1 straight line. So this skill is very good when you use the light resistance down first. After that, with this skill, the opponent resistance will be graded down for both light and slash. And then if you max break these mementos, the BJ ability power ups plus the light resistance down power ups. So it's also very good as well. And then for the mementos leader skill, this is one of the very powerful leader skill. Even though it never increased the HP, but it increased the physical attack 30% and slash attack 30% and strong versus a dark 20% and dual gain plus 10. Quite good actually. And then good against a greed and gluttony. So even if you're not fighting against a greed, the overall power is quite high, but of course if you're fighting against a greed boss, the power will be increased at now 40% or gluttony 20%. And then for the gears, okay, this weapon is from the gear summon. Well, it increases a lot of physical attack and dex and speed. So this will be the good katana for her. And then the weapon ability is very simple. For the one turn, it increases her physical defense and magic defense times 2.5. So it's only for defensive. And for the alternate choice, you can use this katana from the Yomi mementos, but all of her skill is a slash attack, it's not a magic attack, and she's a light unit. So the only increase is only the physical attack and speed, but that is good enough. But the weapon ability is not very powerful for her. And of course, if you don't have those weapons that is from gear summon or mementos, you can equip with this Kadanoba or Zen Katana. Well, it greatly increases the HP as well, and some physical attack and critical. So it's also not bad. And then this 3 katana, well, it's from the Shinobina collaboration, also from the FGG. So this 3 katana is also a free, you can use them as well. But the overall status is only increased some bit, but at least it's better than nothing. And then for the second gear, this armor is from her limited swimsuit mementos. It increased a lot of HP and slash attack up, and also debuff turn plus 1. So all of her debuff will have one more turn. And then for the weapon ability, it is a very strong light slash attack. Well, it's very simple. It's a super powerful light slash attack. The skill power is 500%. It's same as a Dark Clamorer skill damage. But compared to the Dark Clamorer, the jewel cost is only 50. It's quite cheap. And then if you don't have this armor, you also can equip with this free armor that is very easy to get from the tutorial. It increases the HP and jewel gain, and best part, the weapon ability, HP regen. So this armor will be the best alternate choice. And then for the next gear, this accessory is from her Battle Time 3 mementos. It increases the light attack and accuracy and evasion. So it's also one of the very good free accessory you can use for her. And the weapon ability is, it is an aerial HP recover skill, but this skill consumes her HP in order to heal your ally. So this skill is not really that bad, especially there's no jewel cost for emergency use as well. But then for the alternate accessory, this accessory is from the gear summon. It increases a lot of HP and physical attack, but these two status will not include if you have the good katana and the armor. But good thing is, it has single attack plus 10% plus strong versus giant 50%. So if you're fighting against a giant unit, this will be the best accessory for her, since most of her very powerful skill is a single attack. And then the other alternative is, this accessory is from one of the events that is from Shayna, I think. And it increases the dex and speed, but she does not need any blow attack. But then for the weapon ability, for the every actions, she will have permanent increase of all parameter and can be stacked 5 times. So depending on situation, or if you don't have her katana or any other good armor or accessory, you can equip with this to increase her overall status as well. Okay, next is I'm going to try out at the trading arena. And let's see all of her skill damage is how much, plus with the buff, everything and debuff. Okay, let's go. Okay, let's check her status first. Well, with this leader skill, her HP is okay, but the physical attack is super high, and the death not bad, and the speed okay. And then let's see her normal attacks first. Well, this is a dark unit, that's why the damage is so high, but even you fighting against the other elemental, the damage is almost about 6k. And then next is this skill. Okay, super high damage. And this one. Well, the skill damage increased a bit since the skill attack is hitting two opponents. So the damage is about this. Of course, if there's a lot of opponent within the area, the damage will be even more higher. And then last one. Okay, actually it's nothing much. And then this one. Okay, but the purpose is only for debuff. And then for the master ability, this visual ability is from the limited mementos. Okay, let's see the damage. Okay, but the main purpose is only reduce the light resistance, but the damage is decent. And then lastly is this one. This is from the armor weapon ability from the limited mementos. Let's see the damage. Ooh, suddenly increase a lot. Near 60k, very nice. Okay, next is I'm going to use the 1.4 slash attack up. Let's see all of her skill increase by how much. Okay, let's go. Okay, let's see the normal attack first. Okay, permanent increase anyway. And then this one. Okay, some beat. And this one. Okay. And then this one. Nice. And the side ability, this one. Okay. And the master ability for the visual ability. Okay, a bit. Lastly is the web ability. Wow, 67k. Okay. Okay, next is if the opponent have the slash resistance, let's see the damage increase by how much for all of the skill. Okay, let's go. Okay, let's see the normal attack first. Ooh, 10k, nice. And this one. Ooh, 33k. And this one, 21k, okay. And this one, 19k. All big damage. But I think this skill will be the lowest. Yeah, 11k only. And then this one, also nice. Lastly, this one. Ooh, 90k. Okay, next is if the opponent have the light resistance down, this one. Let's see the overall damage increase by how much. Okay, let's go. Okay, let's see her normal attack first. Okay, not bad. And this one. Okay, nice. This one also quite nice. And this one. Okay. And then this one. Okay. And this one. Okay, a bit. Lastly, this one. Whoa, managed to hit 60g. Okay, lastly is if she have the physical attack 1.5, let's see the total damage increase by how much for all of the skill with the debuff everything, of course. Okay, let's go. Okay, let's check her status first. Well, it's only just 1.5, so nothing much. But if you have any support like Bota that increase her physical attack a lot, plus the dash and speed, so that her overall damage will be increased. Okay, let's see the normal attack. Ooh, for one turn anyway. And this one. Ooh, near 50k, nice. And this one. Okay, quite nice. And this one. Also not bad. And this one. Okay, nothing much. And the master ability, this one. Okay. Lastly is the insane damage skill. It's only 1.5 physical attack. It's not time to plus Bota extra buff and so. And that's up and everything. Some more the resistance down is not the maximum. Can be even higher. Well, basically Suzuka has become quite powerful with the new mementos and the weapon ability from the gear, plus the skill adjustment everything. She become a super powerful attacker out of nowhere, seriously. She can be very good in raid boss and normal ES quest or hell quest and so. But then the skill weapon ability is from the new memento, so minimum you need to get the mementos in order to make her very powerful. As well as her mementos group skill is very good and the leader skill. So if you really want to use her, you might as well aim for her new mementos. And that's it. Since the old mementos is a free mementos and the rest you can get from the gear summon or maybe Yomi katana and so. And then she will be very powerful with all the Kaigan everything. Okay, so that's all about Suzuka. Okay, thank you for watching this video. If you guys got any question about her, please comment. Please thumbs up and subscribe if you like this video. See ya, sayonara. すぐに終わる。しかも踏み込みが甘い。行くぞ。ありがとう。行くぞ。覚悟せよ。行くぞ。
見たか？拙者の力を。